Hi, it's me, Debbie, and I'm here today because I got quite some comments about the construction of my album. Thank you for that. But also a couple of people who were asking how I created it, how the construction is actually. And so I thought I'll do a video on that. But first I want to show you that I did some extra embellishing. Not too much, but just, well, I was playing around and such. So I made another stick pin to go at the front. I need to secure that. And I also did a dangling charm thingy. And this thing I just used a standard paper clip that I clipped on the sides because it doesn't have rings or holes or anything like it. And so what I did is just put on some cute trims and fibers I got from Karen. I also, well, I'll just pull it off so you can see better. So here it is. And I also made a chain with some charms. This is actually a knotted twine that I did. I made a square knot and such. And then this is the charm chain. And what I did was using well, charms I have, of course. So there's a butterfly up here, a cute little bird, a heart, a clock, and a couple of these I got, well, in rags and out of my stash and such. And the clock I got from Cassie, I think. Not sure, though. I think so. And this is actually just an image from the collection that I glossy accented and backed up with some pattern paper, and I put it on some rings to act as a charm. So that's what I did. So now I'll show you the construction of the album. And just a reminder about the pages. I did two kinds of pages, and this is the first one that has two flaps like this and bottom space for tags. And at the back side, also a little flap like this and a big tag on the inside. So this page is actually done this way. I've used a couple of envelopes, and these are just standard envelopes. And of course you can use any size you have, and I just used the cheaper ones. And what I did was I first glued everything shut, like so. And then I put two together, and for this page I sliced open the top just by removing just the sliver at the top, so it has two pockets for the big tags. And to make the flaps I used some more envelopes, and I actually used one envelope that I cut into two parts. I've also made a fold like this. Just a bit, you don't need much. Did the same thing here. And that's what I stick in there. And before I glue these, I also removed the top part. Of course I cut it, but I don't have my knife here. So I removed the flap actually. So this one I didn't shut down. So this gave me the two folding flaps, and at the front I used this one, and I just slide it between here to create this flap, as you can see. And at the back side I've put it actually with the fold the other side, and I've put it between the sides, so you have this pocket. So again, at the front I've got this half sandwiched between the two regular envelopes, creating a flap like this. And the back side I've used the other side of the envelope, which I sandwiched with the pocket on the front side. As you've seen, I've also added another flap to the front, which I what I did was just using another envelope that I glued shut, and I folded it how much I wanted the flap to be. So I folded it about something like this, I think, yes. And I also just sandwiched it between the two envelopes. So like that. And that was creating the first kind of page. Looks simple, right? So there's this part. And again, I cut a sliver from here to create pocket on the side. I've used half an envelope here and half an envelope at the back. So I hope this is clear, and of course I inked all the edges before I put the paper down, and I just used a new color of the spring series, the peacock feathers, but of course you can use colored envelopes or make your own envelopes, or even buy all kinds of ink, or whatever you like to do with your envelopes. But this is the basic construction of the first page. So I'll just go over it one more time. So the base is two envelopes sandwiched together, just like this. The closed side facing each other, and then I just sandwiched another whole envelope between it, which I folded and cut a sliver off at this side, and two half envelopes, one at the bottom and one at the back side of the page, with the pocket at this side and the pocket at the inside. But of course you could also reverse this, so if you like the pocket at the front side, you just fold it the other way, and you could have something like this. So just play around and find your own construction, what you like and such. And you could use all kinds of sizes, or even use a corner envelope for this part, and just something you want. So on to the next kind of page is this one. So it has a front like this with some cuts here, a back like this, two big tags at the sides, and two smaller tags at the top. So the way I created this, I'll show you. Again, I used two basic envelopes for the base, and this time I did glue them down, but I made a sliver at the right side instead of the opening. So just at the right side for the big tags, so they each fit into one envelope. And to make space for the two little tags, I used again two of the half envelopes, like so, and which I did was actually just fold them like this and glue them between the two envelopes. So I just glued these in between these, and just you want some room. For example, I did something like this, and then you can place your tags inside here. So tags inside here, because this has a sliver, big tags in the envelope. And that's all there's to it, except I also, as you can remember, had a flap on the back side. Well, you can use anything. You can use another envelope, which you would sandwich like this, so it also has a pocket or something. But what I did was actually just use a piece of cardstock. Just imagine this is a piece of cardstock which I made a fold that would make the sandwich, and glued it between there. So that's there's all to it. So I'll take you through this page one more time. I had two basic envelopes with a sliver of it at this side to put a big tag in one of these envelopes. And in between I sandwiched two of the half envelopes. Again with a folded edge so the tags won't slide out for the tags. And I also had a flap, which of course you have to glue behind those envelopes, otherwise your tags won't go in. So it would look like this. And then this flaps down. Like so. And of course you make sure the dimensions are whatever you want. You can make a just a small flap or use any kind of dimension. So I hope you find this clear enough, and I'll show you just one more time in the book how it looks. So that creates these kinds of pockets with two flaps at the half envelope and a long envelope, and room for big tags in one of the each envelopes, and half an envelope this side. And this page I actually only slide through the pattern paper, and I made little holes at the end of the paper so the slice won't go any further, because if you don't end it like this it might tear up and tear all the way down, and with a circle at the end it doesn't, so you use just a little circle at the end to do that. And this is the base, two envelopes, slice at the side, two little ones in between, and the flap in between. Okay. If you have any more questions, just let me know. If you want to do this again, more slowly, or if you want to make another example but you're not sure on how to do it, just ask away, and I'll see you on my next video. Bye for now. Bye.